Managing your data flows and connections can be very challenging in a complex IT landscape. Cloud platform integration can enrich, secure, and manage your data flows in a flexible way without having to build custom logic in your ERP system. Hi, my name is Ali Celiker and I'm an integration consultant at McCoy & Partners. In our previous video, I showed the purpose of CPI and the differences between PI and PO. As you might know, the support for PI/PO is limited till 2030, which makes it even more important to consider the movement to CPI. In this video, I will demonstrate the first looks of CPI and explain how CPI can be used to manage your purchase order processes. But first, let's have a recap on what we have discussed last time. CPI is SAP's cloud-based middleware system that allows integration between on-cloud and on-premise applications. It can easily connect to third-party and non-SAP products. Cloud platform integration focuses on complex integration processes with large-scale pre-packaged solutions. It allows you to remove the custom-built logic from your S4HANA system to CPI, just to keep your core clean. Keeping the core clean, what does it actually mean and why is it so crucial in nowadays ERP landscape? Keeping the core clean refers to the practice of minimizing customization and modifications to your core ERP system, such as the movement to S4HANA, or leveraging cloud-based services provide additional functionalities, extensions, and innovation. This results in an increase in agility, a decrease in development costs, and future-proof architectures. More information on how to keep your core clean? Subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow our LinkedIn page for more content. Now let's have a look on today's business case. As a business owner, you purchase resources for your business. You have a couple of suppliers that deliver your resources. And when new resources are necessary and need to be purchased, your system will create an order and send it to your supplier. However, you cope with a few problems. The first problem is the way your backend system creates the order is not in line with how your supplier can receive and process the data. Thereby, you don't want to connect your own backend ERP system directly to your supplier's backend system to avoid creating custom-built logic and security in your backend system. At this stage, CPI can easily solve these problems. In this demo, you will see that our order structure is different compared to the supplier's order structure. We will map the fields to have equal structures that are readable by our supplier's backend system. This is the landing page of the SAP integration suite. As you can see, you have the recent integrations, the recent artifacts, and you have the monitoring aspects. As you can see, the monitoring message traffic, you see the errors if there are any. So you see in one overview what the actual statuses are of your integrations. On the left side, you see all functions of the SAP integration suite, starting with Discover. Here you can find all best practices provided by SAP. Below you have the design artifacts, so you can build your own integrations and see all the integrations which are built. You have test APIs. You have the configuration of APIs and the monitoring artifacts. So here can you see all traffic, all data that is going through your CPI. This is also an aspect that we will discuss in the next episode. Now let's have a look at the best practices provided by SAP. You see that there are 592 best practices provided by SAP for the most used cases. So there is always a solution to the problem of you. Now let's have a look on the integrations. And let's have a look on the package that I have created for us demo. As you see that I create a name with CPI demo, with the artifact of the name of the demo of today, which is purchase order EIP to supplier. If you open the iFlow, you see that there are three boxes. The left side ERP is our ERP system. The right side is the ERP system of our customer. And in between, we have the message mapping and the connection details. Now, on the bar below, the blue bar, you see the details when we click on the connections. So, for example, we used the SOAP connection for this case, but this could also be an IDOC or an HTTPS. Now you can find all connection details, security artifacts, everything in the bar below. And now let's have a look on our set header. The header is used to find your iFlow in the message monitor process. We gave the name SAP application ID with the source value purchase order number to find our purchase order in the monitoring. This will help us to find an error. Now let's have a look on the mapping we have created. We mapped our purchase order to the target purchase order of our supplier. Now let's have a look in detail how this is looking. This is how the message mappings look like. On the left side, you see your order structure that we want to send to the supplier, and on the right side, the supplier's order. So we have to make sure that our order needs to be processed and goodly received by the supplier. Therefore, you see that there are naming differences. So in the naming conventions, you see that we use supply country and that they expect country. Another thing is that there are fields that we don't have in our structure as the total amount. So therefore, we have to create them. Therefore, we multiplied the unit price by the quantity to meet the request of the structure, so to create the total amount. Another thing is that you see also differences in shipment date. We use the European format and they expect the American format. So this is crucial to map the structure with the date trends. Another thing is that you see that they use text code and that we send text. So we need to map these fields to receive, to send the correct data. Now let's simulate the order. We can do this in CPI without sending the data to the supplier. On the left side, you see the order structure, the message that we are going to send to our supplier. And if the simulation is done, we will see the output message. This process can take a couple of seconds. Now let's have a look on the final output. Now you see that there are still differences, but all fields are filled. If you watch closely, you see that the purchase order ID that we had created at the beginning is correctly mapped. You see McCoy TV 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, which is correct. There are still naming conventions, naming differences, but the maps, the messages are filled correctly. You see that we use item name and that they expect material name, which is correct. So these fields are mapped directly. You also see that the total amount is now filled because we have multiplied the unit price and the quantity as shown. And you see also that the text code is filled. So this process can be taken into account successfully. Now let's have a look back on the HTTPS request to the supplier. Now have a look back on the iFlow we have made. Now you see that we created the order, mapped the order, but now we have to send it to the supplier. So we send it with an HTTP request. You see the direction is a receiver and the adapter type is HTTP. Therefore, we send it to address cpidemo.com as an example. Now, if we deploy this artifact, the order will be placed and the supplier will receive our purchase order. Now, let's have a look on the monitoring process. This is the landing page of the monitoring in CPI. You see all datas and all errors that are occurring. More information about this topic will be provided in the next video. On the next episode, we will provide knowledge about the monitoring processes and how to develop integrations with CPI. Interested in more videos like this? Stay tuned!